for the third week in a row, the Trojan football team had their game come down to one final play. After dominating the UAB Blazers early on in the ballgame, UAB staged a second-half comeback and sealed the win against the Trojans with a controversial 44-yard Hail Mary touchdown catch that gave the Blazers the one-point victory.
Things that I'd like to say, but, you know,
I'm not going to blame it on anybody on our team. I felt like, you know, our team, we did all we can do. You know, I definitely feel like we were beat by more than UAB today.
It was almost like a bad dream, you know. Seemed like all day long it was headed toward right where it ended up.
At the end of the day, it just came down to who wanted it more. And obviously UAB showed us that today. Us as a team, as a defense, as an offense, we've got to do better.
Good way to end that one on the jump ball in the end zone. Me personally, I thought he was short of the end zone, but I guess the ref, they seen something else.
On the final play of the ball game, UAB quarterback Brian Ellis threw up the Hail Mary pass with no time left on the clock. The controversial play ended with Blazer wide receiver Jackie Williams snagging the ball out of midair for the game-winning touchdown. However, a video replay in the stadium appeared to show that Williams may have been just short of the goal line, but after video review,
the ruling on the field stands.
Officials upheld the call.
Well, you know, I'm going to be biased about that. I can't see it from up there, but, you know, didn't look like the ball crossed like his head might have hit him, but that's it. You know, like I said, I felt, you know, a little iffy on a bunch of stuff all day, you know, but that's what they get paid to do, and they do it to their best ability.
Oh, I couldn't tell. I mean, on the replay, it looked like he had the ball on about the 1 foot line, but, you know, I don't know what the officials saw when they reviewed it.
I was hoping to overturn it because me personally, I thought he was short of the end zone, but I guess the replay official in the booth seen something different, and I guess they made the right call. I don't know how to watch the replay.
Leading up to the controversial one-point loss to the Blazers, the Trojans were defeated when UAB marched down the field from their own one-yard line with just 69 seconds left on the clock and zero timeouts remaining.
It's real devastating, not saying that we gave up, but we kind of went a little conservative towards the end of the fourth quarter and stuff. And I think we should have kept our foot on the pedal.
We were supposed to dominate all around, not even just the first half, the third, the fourth. I mean, it was about 45 seconds left on the clock. Like I said, it just came down to who wanted it more. And, you know, hats off to UAB. They wanted it more at the last minute. The wide receiver made a good catch. Whether if it was supposed to be ruled or overruled, they got it done.
Head coach Larry Blakeney says that despite the back-to-back losses, he has had teams in this position before and knows they can overcome adversity.
We've had some other tough times in this particular locker room, and I told the team about it. You know, in 2006, we lost 21-3 up here. And that team went on to win the league and go to a bowl, and that'll be the challenge to these guys to try to do the same thing. Conference play starts next week, but this one is a bitter pill to swallow, I promise you that.
Between the two losses for the Trojans, just one play affected the outcome of each game, the difference between being 3-0 and 1-2.
I believe that every man should go home tonight and look in the mirror and see whether or not if they did contribute today and whether if they're going to contribute in the following games to come. Because to be honest with you and to be direct, we don't need nobody on this team that's not willing to work and willing to go that extra mile. Because if so, they can leave.
Next week, the Trojans kick off Sun Belt Conference play when they host the Arkansas State Red Wolves from Veterans Memorial Stadium. Taylor Burke, Troy Trojan Vision Sports.